YouTube, what's going on? Welcome to the YouTube video. Back again with another one. Bitcoin PPI report, which is obviously the producer price index. And obviously we've got some more Bitcoin news to go over as well. So if you guys are looking forward to the video and you guys do like these videos every single day that I post, literally all day, every day, smash a like button, make sure you subscribe and share the video out to your friends who would like it and find this video useful. I really appreciate that and it helps grow the channel a lot. Just like you guys here, smash the like button. 18 of you liked, amazing. I said if we could get 20, we're very, very close. That's all right. If we get 22 this video, I'll be really, really happy. And that support channel tons. I make sure you guys are sharing the video as well. Thank you to Nicholas King, Patriot for Life, and Easy Call Darmus. I know the rest of the bots. But yeah, thank you all for commenting. If you guys do want to be in the next video, make sure you comment down below and I'll read through your comment. So yeah, as you can see here, it's just a wicked video, man. Do you like to mess things up? Definitely. Great info as usual, Ben. Thank you, mate. And like button smashed. Awesome. And yeah, so what I want to go over first, I haven't clicked any Bitcoin news right now. I want to show you guys what's actually popping on there. You can see Bitcoin's on a steady increase right now. I'll go over the reasons why that currently is in just a little bit. But you can see here, how Bitcoin's strong correlation to stocks could trigger a drop to 8,000. That is an important one. I was going to click on this one, but another one that I was thinking about was this one. Bitcoin finds key trend line near 20K as US dollar index hits new 20-year high. And this is interesting simply because if we go to the dollar right now, the dollar's surging, okay? It's gone up a lot. Like I said to you guys yesterday, I had this price target on my chart for just over 2 months now when we were down here. And we kept climbing to it. Took a while, but we got there. And I'm really happy about it. And I thought we'd get resistance here and start coming down. And that would indicate Bitcoin to pump upwards, right? But as you can see, we went all the way up to 109. And now we're falling back down. If we do find support here, around this level of the EMAs, like we have done here and here and here, then we could see another rise, one upwards. I do have a lot of people saying 113, so that could be a possibility. I haven't seen why it's 113 myself. We could try and find out why that is just for a second. If you could look on the weekly, there could be some past resist support right there. Okay, I see why it could be 113-ish. So 113 is around this level right here. So if we look at the charts, I believe it could be 112 would be a suitable level. If I draw a little box, so that's 114, 113 is the bottom of that. Okay, so I'll go over in a second what I'm on about. I think this is gonna be our likely resistance point for the DXY if we do make it up here, simply because of, you can see here, right here, we topped out. Right here, a little bit choppy. Right here, we got resistance. Right here, we got support. And that's it. So that's the key place. We've already passed all these previous resistances right here, the strong ones that we were actually worried about. So now we just got to focus on these upper parts. So I do believe it's like 100, in between 112 and 114. So yeah, that would be actually a decent place to mark a top for the DXY. A temporary top anyway, like not final top. Let's drag that all the way across so we can see when we hit that, we know when there could be a potential pump happening for Bitcoin, right? So yeah, keep that in mind, guys. But yeah, so literally what I wanted to really show you guys, if we click on Cointelegraph, what this is basically saying is, so the stock market, because Bitcoin has been correlated quite strongly to us, when DXY, when the Dow starts moving, tech stocks, Bitcoin is seeing that big drastic drop at the same time. So is that good news? No. Okay, everyone thought Bitcoin was the inflation hedge. Maybe in the future it will be when it's being held as such a like gold, okay, but the more scarce version, the most useful version, because you can't exactly mail gold bar in the mail and send it off to someone. You can do it in Bitcoin in 13 to 20 minutes, you can send it to someone. But obviously there's better quick coins to do that, but it's the scarcity of Bitcoin which is obviously attracting people. So that's one thing to think of. But you can see here, so that's the Bitcoin price drop, came from down from 48K to 20K as the stock started to decrease. Traders are afraid of regulation and contagion. On July 11th, the Financial Stability Board, a global financial regulator including all G20 countries, announced that a framework of recommendations for the crypto sector is expected in October. So obviously people are scared about regulation because they know that the Fed is going to hike down on it. And they're thinking, okay, are they going to take the crypto out of crypto? Do you see what I mean? Like the privacy awareness, just like Litecoin putting that privacy mimble-wimble in so that you could barely see where the transactions are going and who to, so it's like a lot more private. And that's why some exchanges are delisting them. You can see here, to date with Voyager, The firm continues to seek either a recovery plan or bankruptcy. According to Voyager, the firm still holds $650 million worth of claims against the 3 Hours Capital. So the exact numbers of customer assets remain unknown. So basically, they're not telling us how many customers, how the value of how many of the customers have lost money. They're basically saying just how much they are losing towards 3AC, which is bad because it shows a lack of transparency really, really badly. So you can see here, the negative news flows was reflecting the CME's Bitcoin futures contracts premium. This data measures the difference between longer-term futures contract and the current spot prices. And currently, we're looking at a slight premium, and it was currently sitting bang on central. So, yeah, it says here that it's indicating as a bearish sentiment present. So, yeah, it could be just came downwards, hanging, and potentially another big drop to the downside. But, yeah, another one I want to show you guys is the PPI, Producer Price Index. So this is showing that wholesale prices have shot up to a near record high to 11.3% in June because of the energy costs. It's not just because of the energy cost, of course. You can see here, inflation hit hard at the wholesale level in June as producer prices surged a near record amount from a year ago today due to a big jump in energy costs. I think it was about 10%, yeah. 10% increase in final demand energy is what accounted for the 90% increase in that to 11%. So a big chunk of that jump was because of energy, gasoline, natural gas, oil, and other price and other products such as those. So it's not looking good, because if the PPI typically goes forward, that's what people are using to actually predict the CPI. So if the PPIs have gone up, they know that they're going to increase the prices even further of these products, which in turn increases the inflation, which in turn will make the CPI increase. See where I'm coming from? Because CPI is based on inflation and prices going upwards. And if the PPI is going up, that means companies have to re-raise their prices, so it makes the CPI come up again. So that could indicate that the next CPI would actually be higher, which we don't want to see, because we do know that we're actually increasing the Bitcoin price and things simply because people are expecting it to be the peak inflation. What we can see here, I'm not too worried about this pump. I know one of my patrons did actually buy in short the FOMO, got FOMO'd out here on the breakout and shorted 19K and is in a big loss. So I don't want you got anybody to do that. I always say risk management is key, and to do that is how you manage your risk, okay? So like if you back test, you can see here on this chart, look at this. I show this all the time because it's so easy to look at. You came up, you came down. You came up, you came down. You swooped down and you went up. You swooped down and you went up. And then you had a big drop down. Then you had a big drop down. And then you had a big drop up. Big pump up, I mean. And now look where we are. Okay, so we could see that little pump extend a bit higher to 21.4. I can measure the move actually properly with a fib. And I'll show you guys where we could expect a move to match this previous high. See where I'm coming from? Yeah, I can do that for you guys. So this is how you do it. You go to the fib. You just go from the top of that fib to the bottom of this fib. And there you go. So you can see that we perfectly touched a 786. And then we came back down for that big move downward. Okay. So if we mirror this move, that means we need to hit the 786. Sound perfect? Sound easy enough? Yes. So you go down to here. 786. Ooh, okay. 786 puts us around this level right here. Bang on here. 21,662. Is that good for Bitcoin? Of course it's good for Bitcoin. It's pumping Bitcoin. But think about the amount of people who would put in longs at this level. We get above this resistance zone, people put in longs, and then we come back down. Confluence, confluence, confluence. That's what I always tell you to look for. So you can see here, well, this is what I would say. We'd wick above, just like we did here, the resistance, I don't know, just right here, and then we come crashing down. It sounds easy enough, doesn't it? The EMAs could cross, that is bullish for Bitcoin, just like here, just like here, just like here, and then I carry the pump. But here was a fake out, so could be a fake out right here. But I do think we could see a nice quick pump, bang, okay, which you have to look for. We can see a pump towards 22.7, just like here, and it could be a fake out to an extended, and then come back down. But you have to understand that the markets are extremely volatile. I haven't been trading Bitcoin for about 2 or 3 days now. And if you guys are looking for a crypto group which is focused on earning money, teaching you how to trade properly the right way, giving you incentives to how to learn how to trade, video analysis, how to learn how to trade, how to literally see what I'm doing before I'm entering a trade, what I'm looking for, signals. I look at this yesterday. That's over $6,000 in profits Look at that. AUD USD, 1,400. USD CAD, 3,500. Okay, absolutely massive. And then obviously there the day before, and there the day before, and then the day before, where is it? There we go. And before that, bang. So I do kill the Forex markets completely. If you guys are looking for Forex trade as well, we do them as well, and they're included in the package. It's very cheap. We haven't gained any patrons in a while, but every member that's in right now is absolutely loving it. I can say that with my whole heart. You guys can join if you don't like it, you get full refund. And trust me, guys, it is very well worth it. But where do I think Bitcoin is going in the short term? First, I want to show you guys the hourly. So you can see here, we're currently forming this bull flag. Okay, bang, bang. This would actually indicate us a measured price move of, look how perfect that is. Just above our 21.6. Literally, guys, I show you guys it just like that. Just like that. So you guys do appreciate that. Smash that like button right now and subscribe. That's how easy it is to find. You have a look at the markets, no one to look for. And you can see, look at past. So that's one confluence to downside. Pump up, another confluence to the downside because we're above resistance. Could wick above it. Okay. We're in an overall bear market, which is another one. So there's a lot of things pushing us downwards. And if I show you guys a weekly, this is where I will be targeting my move downwards. If we overall see a pump, I think we could see a biggest pump get to about 28K. So if we do see a massive, massive pump, yeah, that's where I'm targeting. That's what I was short at the 2618, okay? And you can see how perfect that is on our fib as well, 2618, okay? Of course, we would first get resistance at, what price is that? 25.4, which is our previous low, which I don't think we'll beat that. Even if we do get to that level, it still forms a higher low. So, you know, it's nothing too bad. The markets have to move like this. It's a bear market. Yeah, we're going to get those big pumps and dumps. We can't change anything about that. The only thing we can do is appreciate it, wait, be patient, and know that we're going to buy at our designated HODL spot for the future. And that's when we make our 10x gains. That's it for today's video, guys. But I just want to show you guys what I was talking about that higher low. It'd be like this. Okay, so maybe it'd be like that. So we could see a nice pump towards about 22, 23, keep us in this zone. But overall, we are literally trending downwards in a big wedge. So that's what I'm saying, like, we could come down right here. This is what I'm looking for. Like, we could see us drop down to 13K, hold that level, fall down a bit more, come back up, fall down a bit more, hover, and then see a nice growth. It's a patience game right now. Be patient, subscribe to me, I'll keep you updated every single day, and I'll see you in the next one. Peace.